Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred, and it looks like my whole desk looks like it's exploded with printed paper, and I think I just added stamps on my right die cuts. It's just a total mess, but who cares? So I'm gonna grab my mixer stand, and I just want to say that, I'm talking about memory decks again. I can't stop talking. So now I have just, in the past, I bought just one memory decks metal die. And I didn't think about, hey, I'm gonna buy a second one, third one, because I didn't know what it means to me and how much fun it's gonna be. So I grabbed this stack of pen and paper that's just single printed. And I have cut just, let's see, this side, so I can fold it here. Let's see if I can grab one. Let's just grab something, yes? So it's the same size, but it's a different pattern, but it doesn't matter. Everyone follows me knows that I love buildings and houses, even though I don't have a lot of washi tape of that, but that doesn't matter either. I'm looking for my, where did I put that? Oh yeah, that's a thing, right. There is it, my bone folder. Okay, so that's what I mean. So this little piece I just cut from here with a pair of scissors. I fold it with a bone folder, and that was gonna be like this, a memory decks folder. So I thought to myself, I did show you how to do the vellum like this, how to punch holes in it, and I thought to myself, that's outrageous. That's outrageous. Why? I will show you. I'm gonna grab the whole stack with pen and paper. I don't know if I show you. Yeah, I think I've shown you. My son loves this kind of apples. Okay, not sponsored. He loves this kind of apples. And I had one from this box. So this new box. Like this. I just, how do you say it? Unfolded, and I thought to myself, just let's see, I have another one here. Let's see where I put it. Yeah, I know it's a mess. I'm so sorry. Yes, I made two, so I have to look for that particular thing where I've put it. Is it here? Yes, I think it is. So, there you have it. Finally. So, I just was looking for the print in here, which is the beautiful print. So, I didn't want to take the letters here. So, I told them, hey, there's already a cutout of the heart. So, I want to place my metal die in here. So, I've cut it out. So, you have, so you don't need to buy pen and paper pad. You just find everything that you already want to throw away in the paper bin. We in the Netherlands have a special bin for papers, everything that's papers, like advertisement folders, pizza boxes, egg boxes, or paper egg containers, cardboard. When you order something online, you have this big cardboard box, and then you just fold it neatly so it can fit into the door handle, so you can throw away the paper. But if you go into your kitchen and you have eaten something and you have these cardboard boxes left like this, this is the apple box wrapping outside thingy cardboard. So I've got here beautiful memory decks, luggage, like this. And I did another one from the top. I don't know if you can see it. Wait, I'm gonna put it neatly so you can see it clearly. So I have one here on top, so I don't have the handle. I don't want the handle. And I thought to myself, that is the way to use a puncher, any kind of puncher, to punch hole in it. But if you do it not straight, but a little bit skewed and not underlined, I thought to myself, I have this little piece of sample that I do not use. So I thought to myself, hey, you know what? I know it's a mess. Put the sampler on top like this, and then you put it like in the center. Find your puncher and then punch. Okay, it's not, this puncher is a hole, like a circle. It doesn't have a hole like this, square, but it doesn't matter. It is okay. So you punch, you can make it a bit wider, like this. But don't cut into the sampler, because you're gonna need it, of course, for the next, memory deck card. In this case, I made a folder, as you can see, and I have all these, that book from the route map when you drive a car and you need to see where to drive from one place to the other place. I have these strips of paper, and I thought to myself, well, I can just fold it like this, grab another puncher. This one comes from this score. This is a set, actually. The scoring board, but I don't know where I've put the white puncher. So I have two scoring boards, the white one and the blue one. So actually, you see two different kinds of things. So I have this particular puncher, and I need to make tabs. So I'm gonna put one in like here, or you can do it like completely like, oh wait, like this. Oh, that, so you can have like a rounded one, or you can make if you put it a more not right here at the side, but more to the center, then you create a some kind of tab. So that's what I made. So I'm gonna put it aside. So you can glue it or double side tape on it like this. So here you can see you have a tab. You can put it on this side like so, or you can put it in the center. But the other one, where's the other one? Here you could put it like this, so you can see it's a tab, and write something here, the theme of the folder that you made, or here the memory deck card. You can put it in here, some washi tape that's just one colored, or like I said, the tab. Here you have all these cards like these, you know, like these, and just put the tab on there. It doesn't have to need to be the roadmap paper. You can use just all the bits and pieces of paper that you have no use for it anymore, and it's just wasteful to throw that bits and pieces away. So I'm gonna put it down. So I have this piece of paper, and I made tabs with it. So I fold it like this. And apparently I was practicing, I was thinking like how, it was some time ago, how I made tags or tabs, and I was just playing with it. And I thought to myself, oh, oopsie, that's too short to write something here in between. So I made another one that's a bit longer, so I can write a longer word on there, and just cut it with a pair of scissors here, and then just Okay, make it more beautiful then here with a pair of scissors. Just cut this rough bit away. And you just, oh, it's on the other side. Put it like this. Or if you want the colored, this is the back side, the white side. If you want the colored version, just do it like this. Or you can just keep it the rough way, just like it is. Just like so. And then you can write whatever theme this is. I have, wait. So don't throw this away. This is just the sample how to make the holes in there. So I have, I'm now into the folders, but of course you can make the cards itself. So yeah, so I have all, I'm gonna show you. I have this pen and paper pad. I'm sorry. And I've cut all these bits to make the memory decks cards. And I thought to myself, well, it's a bit wasteful when you have this piece and you don't know what to do with it. And I thought to myself, what can I do with that? So, so for example, I have a bit of paper like this. I can fold it like so. So I can cut with a pair of scissors right in the center, so I can make a memory decks card, or just fold it like this with your nails, or if you have a bone folder, you can create, let's see, you can fit it in the box like this and then make a bigger memory card folder, or like I said, if I cut it in here in the middle, you can have two memory decks cards. And I thought by myself, wait. I have next to me this, okay, not sponsored, from the Chinese supermarket. My son, my youngest son, loves to drink this kind of matcha tea. And I didn't throw away the box. I was thinking about, well, for me it's easier if I just, how do you say it? Take the top and the bottom side off, so I can fold it easily and then store it somewhere here in my desk. But I was thinking about, hey, wait a minute, I have this kind of box. I have more of these boxes, but I want to show you. You have these kind of rectangular boxes. If this was a box that I'd not opened from top and bottom, just only the top like this, so the bottom is secured, this piece of paper, a memory decks folder, fits in it very well. So I can just cut it with a piece of with a pair of scissors the top part off, so that is gonna be out of the picture. So supposedly this is away. So, and then you can fit all these memory decks cards or memory decks folders in there, and put two holes in there like this, or like I just showed you, put two holes in there, and then put two straws in here, two and two, like this, because I don't want to cut it, the straws right in here. I thought to myself, it's more smarter just to fold it like this, and find a paper clip. Okay, smaller paper clip. I have a big paper clip. If you have smaller paper clips, just to put it in there, so it can be it can hold the straws, or you can have how do you say it? Pin clothes. Clothing pins, or whatever thing that you like, chips. When you eat chips and you don't want to eat the whole bag, then you want to roll the bag and then leave the leftover chips for next time. You have this special clips. Yeah, clips. So you can clip it like this, or put some very good tape, or duct tape or whatever, because if you want to, like I said in my first video vlog, if you want to put more papers, I mean the cards with all the lines where you can write better, because now it's blank and you can write it, of course, wonky. So if you have papers that are lined and you can add more papers or more cards, whatever you want, you want to, of course, you need to take the clip away so you can make the straw straight again and remove the straws easily so you can put more paper, more cards, more folders, whatever you want, and rearrange these cards and folders to your liking. I made here a folder and I didn't make the holes, but I was thinking about, well, I want to so this is the tag that I want to do. I just wanted to see how to align all these things. So this card is meant to be like traveling or Europe, so I found stamps that is in that topic. So I was just trying to see how to do this, because of course I cannot glue all these stamps like this. Well, I can, but I need to make the holes down here and glue the tab on there. So that was what I was doing. So I'm gonna put you back in the stand. This kind of folder that is not finished, I had, like I said, I have to put some the two holes in there. So this is a example to, so I can know, so I know where to put the holes with the puncher. It doesn't matter what kind of puncher you have. You like this, the elongated puncher, or puncher like that, or you know the how you make holes with a machine where you can put two holes in there. You can use that. And I thought to myself, I have these big die cuts like these. Where's the thing? Oh yeah. So I can use this one or this one. This is the same size. So it's the same size. And I thought to myself, can I fold it in a different kind of shape? So I grabbed a folder. I wanted to see, like, I like the width, but I don't have enough paper, as you can see. So I thought to myself, well, maybe if I can fold it like this, here's the back side, and fold it like that. Glue it together. Of course, I have to cut away this part because that is too much paper. So it will be easily like this. You can glue it together. So you have like some kind of pocket like this, in case you want to, for example, I have a lot of stamps with art. I love to go to museums, so I have stamps with art like these. Let's see if I have more stamps, like, you see, paintings, sculptures. I put everything in there. Of course, I've already, of course, I punched the holes, but you can put here all the stamps that you want to gift to someone. So I have all these, as you can see, you see all these sculptures, graphic, whatever, just to, you know, just create a pocket. And I thought by myself, well, if I had, for example, an artsy die cut, suppose, just imagine this is an artsy die cut, and I thought by myself, well, I can just glue it on here, find a tab, where's a tab, oh here, find a tab and put it like this, so like this, you see, and then write in here, if it is not auto map, but another kind of paper, And it's a tab. I can glue it in here with double-sided tape or with glue. And then write in here some letters or put a washi tape. Let's see. Do I have washi tape that's clear? Well, supposedly this one is clear, okay? And you put a little piece of washi tape so you can write in here that's art or museum. Museum, yeah. So that's what I'm trying to do now. That's the reason why my desk is so messy. I have so much ideas in my head to create different kind of cards. I want to make luckily I have so much boxes of these. I've collected them over the past year. My son only drinks this kind of latte, matcha latte, and with that box that I've shown you, I can put all the memory dex cards or folders. Of course, I've already punched holes in there, and all I need to do is to decorate so beautifully. Even though I know it's printed so beautifully already, but with the die cards, with washi tape, I have so much things here on my desk. You see, I have washi tapes here, more washi tapes. Well, there is more, of course, but for this case, I was thinking about create a memory dex card topic plants. I have these stickers with plants, and there is also more washi tapes with plants. Okay, some of it is Monstera leaves, I can see here. But I have also here, I have a lot of stickers and washi tape. But I thought by myself, for this topic, house plants, I found this beautiful flaked sticker roll. And all the flaked stickers are put on top of each other. So I have to carefully remove them without tearing them apart. And just decorate, make it more beautiful, this piece of paper. So I have found so much printed paper, and of course there's more, but I was trying to see to decorate some of them, because I have here, oh wait, I will not open this, but in this boxes there's three layers. There's layers of flowers, and these are regular flowers, flowers and the theme Hawaii. So you have the birds like these, the diecast of these cacatoo of birds, pineapples, flowers, things like that are in the second layer. Then I've also butterflies, hence this printed paper butterflies, what I want to turn into a memory dex card or a memory dex folder. And I'm looking for all the die cuts just to decorate it beautifully with the die cuts and the stickers and the washi tapes. So as you can see, there's here printed paper with butterflies. I have washi tape with butterflies, and in there, in this layer, there are more die cuts of butterflies. So that's what I'm doing. I have also stamps with butterflies. Okay, these are not the butterfly ones, but I have stamps of those, and I am just enjoying myself here, having a memory dex decorating frenzy. I'm so sorry that I had to make three different kinds of vlog videos just to make my point. Well, okay, it's a messy desk, I'm sorry. But we are going to decorate and have so much fun, okay. But you at home have all the things that you have, that you bought yourself, or you can draw it yourself, or you got some snail mail things from your pen pal or your snail mailer friend. There are some sources.